This morning in Legal Logic, how to prepare to meet thy pothole and avoid dealing with the grim fate. Back to share info that we really need this time of year. It's attorney Brian Kuna. Good morning, Brian.
Good morning, Will.
Thanks for coming in.
How are you?
Everybody knows, we've all probably done it, been driving down the road, and all of a sudden you can see it coming. You can see it coming, and you do the best you can to avoid it. But some of them basically swallow the car, the potholes.
Swallow your wheel.
Yeah.
That grim pothole.
Yeah,
terrible.
So what happens if you're driving along, and to no fault of your own, you're going along the road and you hit one of these potholes, and it does damage to the tire, to the wheel, some part of the car. What do you do from there?
Cry.
After cry.
You say, uh-oh, here it comes.
Right.
Well, it depends on what state you're in. If you're in Rhode Island, there is a law in Rhode Island, which is a pretty good law. Unlike Massachusetts, by the way, the state law that says if you hit a pothole, you can collect up to $300.
Wow.
Yeah, for the damage to your car. But the time limits are very, very strict. 7 days. You've got to notify the Department of Transportation in writing. Mm-hmm. You got to give them the time, the place, the location, your odometer statement, and information with regard to your registration. You have to be a registered vehicle in Rhode Island. If you're out of state, unless they have a reciprocal law, you're out of luck. But if you do it within 7 days, it's a state road, you can collect $300.
Well,
if it's a town road, it's a
here we go.
Yeah. Different deal. Then you have to do the same thing, but you have to submit it to the town. You have 30 days, though, with regard to the town. But again, you've got the information. You've got up to 60 days to get them all the information.
Right.
And then 45 days after they've approved it, you'll get your money, whatever it is. You have to pay for it too. You're gonna have to give them a bill. You have to pay for it first.
And then send
that,
then send them everything.
You'll get your $300. Massachusetts, though, no law.
Really?
Nope. No state law with regard to claims. Unlike Rhode Island, there's a specific law in Rhode Island. There's no law in Massachusetts.
So we have done something right.
Massachusetts. Their law is 100 years old.
Really?
Yeah. So if you're on a state road, you're out of luck.
Wow.
Okay.
So I know you've told us this before, whether it's an accident, whether someone slips and falls.
Right.
To take a picture. Should you take a picture if you can and it's safe?
If you're on 195, don't do it.
Right.
But if you're in a town road, I mean, I did it in Newport. I mean, I took a picture. I made a claim. They paid me, actually.
That's great.
With regard to towns, you have to do the same thing. Submit a claim up to $5,000. But again, anything over $5,000, Department of Transportation will not give you any money. You have to write DOT. They're located in Rhode Island. Mm-hmm. They're located in Warwick on Lincoln Avenue. I know that. And so you got to do that 7 days. Do it fast.
Now, one of the other things that you were telling me even before we went on the air, that also if something happens to your mailbox.
Oh, yeah. $50.
Really?
Yeah. If a snowplow wipes out your mailbox, again, you have to go through the same procedure.
Right.
You got to write them a letter. Within 7 days, you write them a letter. This is what it cost me to replace my mailbox. They'll pay you up to $50 in Rhode Island. Massachusetts, you're out of luck.
Well,
you're
Brian,
out of luck.
Thanks for coming in. All great information, especially this time of year with the weather cold and warm and then cold again. A lot of potholes. Be on the lookout. If you would like even more legal advice from Brian, you can head on over to roadshow.com and click on the Legal Logic channel.